Hello everyone, welcome back to another session of Community Health and Social Work. We are discussing an nutritional problem of community health and social work. In our previous video lecture, we had discussed on what is nutritional problem, who is at risk. It means whose life is in risk due to lack of nutrition, and also discussed on types of nutritional problem. There is two types of nutritional problem. One is undernutrition and another one is overnutrition. And we are discussing on the type that is undernutrition. And we have just overlooked on some problems which are related with undernutrition. Now in this class, we will discuss more on nutritional problems which are related with undernutrition type. Let's start. First, we will discuss on protein energy malnutrition. A clinical syndrome present in infants and children as a result of deficient intake or utilization of food. It means protein energy malnutrition is a form of malnutrition when a child has lack of nutrients which are required or which are necessary for maintain a healthy life, for maintain a sustained human life. So that if there is lack of nutrients, then that is known as protein energy malnutrition. Means in this nutrient, protein is absence. When we are taking food and we have to take protein type of food to prevent the protein energy malnutrition. When a person or when a child has lack of protein, then the child is under protein energy malnutrition. And it's a medical sign or symptoms through which we can identify them who has the protein energy malnutrition problem. It refers to a form of malnutrition where there is inadequate protein and calorie intake. It is also a form of malnutrition where the children or the person has lack of protein and calorie in their food. It is considered as the primary nutritional problem in India. Protein energy malnutrition is a problem which is major and primary nutritional problem in our country. Due to protein energy malnutrition, it raises child mortality and child morbidity issue. Due to that, many times the children are facing death, and also there is some injuries or some serious or dangerous injuries for their life. And protein energy malnutrition is a reason for child mortality and child morbidity, which is in high rate. Next, we will discuss on diseases or conditions which are related with protein energy malnutrition. And these diseases are, one is kwashiorkor, marasmus, and last one is marasmic kwashiorkor. We will discuss briefly on these diseases. First, we will discuss on the disease that is kwashiorkor. Kwashiorkor is the most common and widespread nutritional disorder in developing countries. It is a form of malnutrition caused by not getting enough protein in the diet. Kwashiorkor is a most common nutritional disorder. Due to lack of protein in our food, the child is facing the issue which is kwashiorkor. When the children are taking food, they have to intake protein types of food in which food they can get the nutrient that is protein. When the children has lack of protein nutrient, then they will face the disease that is kwashiorkor. In kwashiorkor disease, there is some symptoms or there is some issues that are acute illness or infections which are prolonged starvation, measles, trauma, sepsis, and some weight loss, and also high mortality. Next, we will discuss on marasmus. It is a severe form of malnutrition that consists of the chronic wasting away of fat muscle and other tissues in the body. Malnutrition occurs when the body doesn't get enough protein and calories. This lack of nutrition can range from a shortage of certain vitamins to complete starvation. Marasmus is a severe malnutrition which is consists of chronic wasting and wasting of fat and muscles in the human body. And it's also a type of malnutrition where the child has lack of protein and calorie in their food. When the child is not getting protein and calorie, then they will face the issue or the disease which is marasmus disease. In marasmus disease, there is some symptoms that are severe, prolonged, chronic and slow onset, and severe weight loss in marasmus disease, and low motility rather than kwashiorkor issue. Next, we will discuss on marasmic kwashiorkor, a malnutrition disease primarily of children resulting from the deficiency of both calories and protein. The condition is characterized by severe tissue wasting, dehydration and growth retardation. It's also a disease which is related with malnutrition, when the child has the lack of both the protein and calorie, then the child is facing that disease which is marasmic kwashiorkor. And in this disease, the child has severe tissue wasting from her body, and also there is some problem which is growth retardation and dehydration problem due to marasmic kwashiorkor disease. Next, the causes of protein energy malnutrition, which are the reasons related with protein energy malnutrition. Inadequate intake of food. When the child is taking inadequate food, in which food the child is not getting proper nutrient which are required for maintain a healthy life, then the child is facing protein energy malnutrition issue. Next is diarrhea. Sometimes the child has problem which is diarrhea, and due to diarrhea the child is lost their nutrients. So that is also a reason which is related with protein energy malnutrition. Then respiratory infections. Some children have respiratory infections due to some health issues or due to lack of nutrient. So that is also a major reason of protein energy malnutrition. Then measles. Measles is also a problem or also a reason through which the children are facing the lack of nutrients. At the time of measles, they had lost their nutrients because they can't take food, they can't take proper nutritious food. They want to take some tasty foods, so that because of measles, the children are facing the problem which is protein energy malnutrition. Then poor hygiene environment. To maintain a healthy life, we need hygienic environment which is necessary to maintain a healthy life. When the children are living their life in poor environment, there is environment is polluted, and also there is no sanitization, so that children are facing some health issues. Because of these health issues, the children are facing lack of nutrients. They can't get proper nutrients because we need hygienic environment to maintain our proper nutritious food and to maintain a healthy life. When the children are comes from poor hygienic condition or poor hygienic environment, then they are facing different types of health issues which are related with protein energy malnutrition. Then large family size. Large family size is also a reason of protein energy malnutrition, because in a large family there is numbers of members in their family, and the head of the family and also the parents are unable to take care of all the members of the family. Because in a family there is different types of people or different types of members. in a family there is oldest persons, there is children, there is male persons, female persons, and for different category of people there is need of different quantity of nutrients, there is different types of nutrients, so that the family members or the head of the family or the parents can take care of the family members in perfect way. And in a family, if there is many children, then they are unable to providing proper nutritious food or proper nutrients to all the child, and they can't prevent the protein energy malnutrition due to large family issue. Then is poor maternal health. At the time of pregnancy or at the time of maternity, then the mother has to take care of her, because the life of the baby or the growth of the baby depends upon the mother. So that there is need of maternal health. And if there is poor maternal health, means the mother is not taking care of herself at the time of pregnancy, then there is the problem arises, which is protein energy malnutrition. When the mother is not taking proper nutritious food or proper nutrients in her food, then the child will face the problem, that is lack of nutrition, which is related with protein energy malnutrition. Next is failure of lactation. If the mother is failure to giving breastfeeding to her child, then that is failure of lactation. Due to some health issues or due to some lack of nutrients, the mother is failure for providing breastfeeding to the child. That is also a reason of protein energy malnutrition. So that there is need of proper nutritious foods or nutrients for the mother as like as the child. Because at the child or infancy period, the infant growth is depends upon the mother's growth. If the mother will take proper nutritious food, then the child will get all the nutrients in her food. Next is premature termination of breastfeeding. If the mother is terminating breastfeeding in premature period, then the child will face the problem, that is lack of nutrition or protein energy malnutrition. Next is delayed supplementary feeding. If the mother is delaying to providing supplementary feeding, if the child is not taking breastfeeding or the mother is unable to give breastfeeding to her child, then there is need of supplementary food through which the child will get proper nutrients which are required for sustain a better life or healthy life. So if there is delay in providing supplementary food, that will occurs the problems which are related with nutritional problem. There is lack of nutrition for our child. Next we will discuss an assessment of protein energy malnutrition. It means how we can assess the protein energy malnutrition. Means weight for age percentage. There is different types of percentage through which we can assess the protein energy malnutrition. There is a formula which is weight of child into 100 divided by weight of normal child of same age. We have to take an example of weight of a malnutrition child and into 100 and divided by weight of a normal child who is the same age. Means when we are taking weight of the malnutrition child, at same age child we have to take a weight of a normal child. And between 90 to 100% nutrition, that is known as normal nutritional status. If a child is between 75 to 89% of nutrition, that is known as mild nutrition, which is first degree of malnutrition. Then last one is between 60 to 74%, which is known as moderate malnutrition and which is second degree of malnutrition. Next we will discuss an prevention of protein energy malnutrition, means how we can prevent from the issue which are related with protein energy malnutrition. Oral rehydration therapy helps to prevent dehydration caused by diarrhea. It means sometimes children are facing the problem or the issue which is diarrhea. Due to diarrhea, the child are facing different health issues also, and due to diarrhea they are lost their protein or their nutrients in their food, so that they have to take oral rehydration therapy through which they can prevent the protein energy malnutrition, in which they can get the nutrients which are required for them. Next is exclusive breastfeeding for 6 months. Thereafter, supplementary foods may be introduced along with breastfeeds. Means there is a need of supplementary of breastfeedings from 0 to 6 months, because it is necessary baby can get proper nutrients from the mother's milk. When there is a child who is above 6 months, then there is a need of supplementary foods with the mother's milk. They have to provide other foods through which the child can get other nutrients from different types of food. Then immunization for infants and children. A government providing different immunization facilities for infants and children, like hepatitis B immunization, polio. Due to that immunization, they can prevent from different diseases which are occurring due to lack of nutrition. Then nutritional supplements. When the child is not getting the proper food, then the parents or the mother has to providing supplement nutritional food through which the child can get all the nutrients which are required for her age or for her prevention from different diseases. Early diagnosis and treatment. When the parents or when the mother is feel that there is any issues or any problems which is related with lack of nutrition in her child, then that is important to diagnosis or providing treatment in early period, because in early period we can prevent quickly from the disease. So that is important if we want to prevent different malnutrition diseases or different issues which are related with malnutrition, then we have to prevent or we have to providing treatment immediately. Next is promotion and correction of feeding practices. Sometimes children like to take outside food or junk food or fast food items. At that time, the parents have to promote or the parents have to aware about the proper nutrients or the proper nutritious foods and correct their diet chart or correct their food chart. Then family planning and spacing of birth. Sometimes in our society, the people are not aware about family planning programs, and also they are not aware about spacing of birth from one child to another child. They have no minimum gap from one child to second child, so that they are facing problem to survive their life for planning a better life. And if the community people will aware about family planning program, then the society can prevent or can fight against different nutritional problems and can prevent from different nutritional diseases. Next problem is low birth weight, which is under nutrition type. And low birth weight, newborn is any newborn with a birth weight of less than 2.5 kg, which is including 2.499 kg. Regardless of gestational age, those newborn baby who are less than 2.5 kg, which is including 2.499 kg. If a newborn baby is under 2.5 kg, then he is known as low birth weight. and low birth weight occurs different problems. Sometimes due to low birth weight, some children are getting diet and results child mortality and child morbidity issue. And if the low birth weight children alive, then they are facing different health issues as like as heart problems, chronic diseases or chronic illness in their future life. So low birth weight is a major issue which is related with nutritional problem or protein energy malnutrition. Next is causes of low birth weight. First is illness or infections. Due to illness of mother, the child is facing the problem which is low birth weight. If the mother is not taking proper nutritious food at the time of maternity or at the time of pregnancy, then the child will face low birth weight issue. So the mother has to take proper nutritious food at the time of pregnancy. Then short maternal stature. Due to short height of mother, also the problem arises which is low birth weight. Then very young age. Sometimes some girls or some parents are married their girl at very young age. And at young age they are not matured and they have no plan about family. And they didn't know about the family planning programs and spacing of birth. So that in very young age are giving birth to a child. Because of very young age, the low birth weight issue arises in some child's health. Then is high parity. Due to major numbers or more numbers of pregnancy, also the low birth weight arises in sometimes. Then close birth intervals. Some are not aware about space of birth in between one child to second child, and that is the responsibility of the parents, responsibility of the mother, and also the responsibility of family members. They have to aware about space of birth between one child to second child. If there is no minimum space between one child to second child, then it will results or it occurs different diseases which are related with protein energy malnutrition, and low birth weight is a result of that issue also. Next is the cause is IUGR, means intrauterine growth retardation. That means that the baby is growing slowly and doesn't weigh as much as the doctor expected for this stage of pregnancy. That is also a major reason of low birth weight. Next, we will discuss on prevention, means how we can prevent the issue which is low birth weight. Identification of mothers at risk, malnutrition, heavy work, infections, disease and high BP. When the mother is identified as pregnant, then they have to identification of some risk. They have to prevent from different risks. And some risks are malnutrition, and the mother has to take proper nutritious food, and the mother has to avoid heavy work or hard work, and also to avoid the issues and different tensions through which they can results of high BP. They have to avoid that issues through which they can prevent from different infections for which they have risk for their child and for their own life also. Increasing food intake of mother, supplementary feedings, distribution of iron and folic acid tablets. And the mother has to take folic acid and iron tablets and also the supplementary foods from which the mother will get all the nutrients which is necessary at the time of pregnancy or at the time of maternity, because the baby's food depends upon the mother's food. So the mother has to intake more food. Next is avoidance of smoking, and the mother has to avoidance of smoking, and also the family members have to avoid of smoking, improved sanitation methods, and the mother and the family members has to improve their environment and also clean their environment and sanitize their area where the mother is living. Improving health and nutrition of young girls. At the young period, the girl get maturity, and that is the period when the girl is getting her growth and development in her body. So that at the young period of girls, there is necessity of intaking nutrients and intaking nutritious food. Because of different issues, gender discrimination, gender inequality, the girls are not getting proper nutritious food, which is necessary for them at the young period. So that taking nutritious and foods and also through getting proper nutrients, we can prevent the issue. Controlling infections like UTI, rubella, syphilis and malaria. UTI means urinary tract infections. It is majorly caused by bacteria, and any part of the urinary system can affected by it. And rubella is a type of measles. And syphilis means it's a bacterial infection usually spread by sexual contact that starts as a painless sore. And also the mother has to control from the infection malaria, because it causes the barrier in growth and development of the baby in the mother's womb. So the mother has to avoid, and so the mother has to controlling from and make distance from this type of infections, through which the mother can prevent the issue low birth weight of her child. In this class, we had discussed the problem which is related with undernutrition, that is protein energy malnutrition. And under protein energy malnutrition, we had discussed marasmus, kwashiorkor, marasmic kwashiorkor, and the causes of protein energy malnutrition, and also discussed how we can prevent from the protein energy malnutrition issue. And also we had discussed low birth weight and different causes of low birth weight, and also discussed prevention of low birth weight, how we can prevent from low birth weight. And we had discussed that. And in next class, we will discuss some major problems which are related with undernutrition. Keep watching. Thank you. Have a great day.